TP-Link home routers are being targeted in attacks, stealing master passwords from KeePass, and these end-of-life smart plugs can get hacked. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse and this is ThreatWire for May 23rd, 2023. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. A Chinese state-sponsored hacking group called Camaro Dragon has been infecting residential TP-Link routers with a custom malware called Horse Shell. The malware is designed to target European foreign affairs organizations by launching attacks that appear to originate from those residential networks. Now, the attackers gain full access to the compromised routers, allowing them to run commands, transfer files, and use the routers as a proxy for communication between devices. The attackers are able to do things like gain persistent access, and they can move laterally around a compromised network. According to researchers, this malware is firmware agnostic, even though it's currently attacking TP-Link router models, which means that it could be used to attack other vendors. The research firm Checkpoint discovered the Horse Shell TP-Link firmware implant and attributes it to the Camaro Dragon group, which does show similarities and overlap with the previously reported Mustang Panda group. Now, Mustang Panda has been detailed in reports by both Avast and ESET, or ESET, and while there is plenty of overlap in these attacks, that does not necessarily mean that they are one in the same. The attackers may exploit vulnerabilities or brute force the administrator's credentials to install the malicious firmware. The actual method for the deployment is currently unknown, but these are the suspected ways. The malware modifies the router's firmware and web panel, preventing owners from updating and ensuring the persistence of the infection. The Horse Shell backdoor connects to a command and control server, allowing the threat actors to control the compromised devices remotely. Now, if you own an affected device, you can remediate the issue by applying firmware updates, changing the default passwords, and disabling remote access to the router's admin panel to strengthen your own security. Also, install security patches on edge devices and avoid exposing management consoles publicly if you are a network admin. A major flaw in the popular password manager called KeePass was recently discovered by a security researcher known as Vidoni. This flaw, which is now tracked as CVE-2023-32784, could allow an attacker to recover a user's master password for their KeePass vault in clear text, minus the first character, from memory. Now, this works even when the user's database is locked and potentially even if the program is closed. But how does this work? So when a user types their master password, a custom text box field is used, and this entry field leaves traces of each of the password characters stored in the program's memory. In order for an attacker to take advantage of this flaw, they would already need to have compromised the device in some way, such as through physical access or malware, and the password would need to be typed into the program via keyboard, not copied from a clipboard. Now, this text box is used in other places within the program as well, such as when you edit a password, so those contents could be stolen too. Vidoni released a proof of concept of the flaw exploit, dubbing it the KeePass Master Password Dumper, and noted that this affects versions 2.53.1 of KeePass for Windows, macOS, and Linux, and potentially forks as well. It is not patched yet, but a new version of KeePass, which is version 2.54, is expected to drop in June, and users are advised to update to that patch when it is available. Supposedly, this will be within the next 2 weeks, as this will include mitigation techniques such as avoiding the creation of managed strings in memory and obfuscating the real key. Now, in the meantime, you should proceed with caution if using KeePass and also be cautious of phishing attacks or potential programs that you want to download. Biggest of shout outs to my Patreon supporters, especially my golden s'mores and their fur babies for making the show completely possible since we don't have ads in the show at all, except for Patreon. Thank you to Steven as well for being a part of the s'mores at patreon.com/ShannonMorse. That's my new Patreon page. I've mentioned it previously, but I'm gonna mention it again. I will be posting all of the perks for patrons, including early access to this video as well. So if you are currently a patron on the ThreatWire page, switch on over to the new one so you don't lose access to your perks. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story. It's all about Wemo. That smart plug that you use to turn on a lamp has a pretty serious vulnerability, and the brand that made it has no intentions of fixing it. A severe vulnerability, which is tracked as CVE-2023-27217, was discovered in January by the Israeli IoT security firm Sternum and disclosed to Belkin, the manufacturer of popular Wemo smart plugs that enable convenient remote control of electronic devices via voice, smartphones, and tablets or hubs. The vulnerable device in question is the Wemo Mini Smart Plug V2, which is unfortunately coming to its end of life. The flaw is a buffer overflow issue, which could allow a threat actor to inject arbitrary code remotely. They could crash the device, they could run malicious commands, or take control of the device once attacked. Sternum was able to reverse engineer the device and gain firmware access. They discovered that the issue stems from a feature that allows users to rename the smart plug, where the character limit is not actually enforced by the firmware code, even though it is enforced in the application itself. Now, the flaw can be triggered by exceeding the 30 character limit in a third-party tool for device names. Default names usually show up as something like Wemo Mini 6F8, but they can be changed by the user to something like Bedroom Plug 1 to make it easier to identify each plug. By using a Python module, an attacker can trigger a buffer overflow and crash the device or execute their malicious commands. Now, unfortunately, Belkin hasn't embraced the new protocol for IoT called Matter yet, which could allow for local-only support instead of relying on a cloud connection. Belkin does not plan to address the issue, as the device is reaching end of life again and it has been replaced by newer models. Users are advised to avoid exposing the vulnerable smart plugs directly to the internet and implement proper network segmentation in sensitive environments. Otherwise, you could just e-cycle the thing. That's probably what I would do. I'm Shannon Morse. I will see you on the internet.